Ladies and gentlemen, as the owner and founder of UCCW, it is time to make some major change for this company here in UCCW. It started off from low to a global phenomenon here in the virtual wrestling universe. It is now time to step up to a whole new level of success and dominance to the video game wrestling universe. This new guy who's gonna show up right now is gonna run this show for us. And he is gonna change the new background in UCCW. I'm gonna miss you all, and to the wrestlers backstage and staffs and committees, I wish you the best with a new person who's gonna run the show for me. And I'm gonna miss you all. Well, I will still be with you all as your loyal commentator, and I'm still the owner and founder of UCCW. Ladies and gentlemen, let's make this the best to all of us and to all the fans who enjoy watching UCCW. Ladies and gentlemen, the new person who's going to run the show, ladies and gentlemen, I give you Freddie J. Francis!
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
be no stopping. It's when you go harder than somebody, man.
And ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the most epic moment in UCCW history, the 30th episode of Monday Night Warzone. And ladies and gentlemen, we are just getting started with a new era, the new generation of video game wrestling universe, the new generation that would change the history of UCCW. As I, Maddie Dangerously, announces that Freddie J. Francis, a longtime veteran in CAW, is going to take over UCCW as the assistant general manager with Ami Mizuno. Those two are going to run the show as Francis Mizuno era. These two run their shows before back in Vixen Wrestling Federation, and as of today, they are ready to step up to a whole new level to run UCCW. After what happened during their remarkable speech, Trista came out and laid out the reason why Freddie should not belong in CAW ever after she showed this clip of what they did back in long time ago that brought them into a drama. Which I personally think is one of the most disgusting things that Trista's ever shown. I mean, really? Freddie and Ami went all the way in the shower? And that was like a long freaking time ago during the NGW era. As a good old saying goes, once past is past, we move on from this and we move on to the positive past. That's what Freddie did. He moved on, he's on the right path, he's on a strong future for him in CAW. What Trista did was low, shameful, and disgusting. And I hope you like what you did, Trista. That was a heinous move, and you regret what you did. Trista's gonna face Ami Mizuno in a 3-on-3 elimination series match in a right to see who will become the commissionership of UCCW. And here we go, we sorry about this. If I take this for a long time, I was not happy from what Trista did. It was horrible. She should not do that. It was bad from her, and she should be shameful for this. And Freddie's taking this in a strong, matter way. Good for him. And I wish my best friend the best of luck in this new job as assistant general manager with Ami Mizuno. And now, here we go. I'm sorry about this, but here's a match. Jax versus Terry Bogard, Mortal Kombat, and the King of Fighters. And the winner of that match will be in the final entry in the first ever Ultimate Survivor match for the Intercontinental Championship at Elimination Series 2. This is going to be huge, folks. The last time we had the Ultimate Survivor match, it was all the way back in Showdown Season 2, Episode 4, I believe. It was Dominator, Ogre, Grave Robber, and Bowser. And the winner in that one gets a title shot. And then, I mean, no, it wasn't Ogre. Was it Ogre? Was it? No. It was Grave Robber, Bowser, Dominator, and Captain Falcon. Right. The winner in that match gets a title shot against Ogre's World Heavyweight title in Summer Smash. And Grave Robber was the last survivor in this match and earns a title shot. He last eliminated Captain Falcon. Oh, what a punch by Jax. So in this Ultimate Survivor for the Intercontinental Championship, we got the defending champion, Mist Montone. And we got Justin Jericho getting his revenge rematch for the title. And we get the first woman ever, Ezdeath, competing for the Intercontinental Championship. We might witness a history since 1999 where China beat Jeff Jarrett for the Intercontinental title. And you know what happened to Jeff Jarrett afterwards. Oh! That hurts. Missed a leg drop. And now Terry did something stupid. Try and piss him off. Uh-oh. This is not... Oh! What an elbow. Flying elbow right in the face. Going for the pin. Two. Kick out. They're on their feet. Ladies and gentlemen, we're almost there to our co-main event. Dio Brando versus Akuma is going to happen tonight. And then your main event, folks, Bane versus The Rock for the VGWGP Undisputed Heavyweight Championship of the World. That is coming soon, folks. Missed a super kick. Oh! Back and forth. Got him. Neck breaker. And now Terry's doing it again. Kicking him in the face. Telling him to get up. That's a wrong way to do that because you don't want him to be pissed off at... Yep, here we go. Oh, there it is. The punch. Jax. The attitude of this mind. The machine is the one you do not want to mess with. One, two, he's gonna get it? No. Back and feet. Now, full Nelson choke slam. That's vicious. Pinned away. Can he do it? One, two, no. Goes in the rope. Uh-oh. Whoop! Oh! Knocking out of the ring. Terry Bogart. Oh, he's got something. He's got something. Here it comes. Got him. Nice diving move by Bogard. To see who will be in the Ultimate Survivor match with the three of them who are already in at Las Vegas. This is one crazy story. Freddie J. Francis going to run UCCW with Ami Mizuno. Three tournaments continue on. Dio Brando, Akuma. The feud continues on from the Bullet Club and the Phantom Blood. Mizuno and Tristan Mio are going to end this civil war to see who will get the run as a commissionership of UCCW. The Seiru Senshi War is out of hands since the beginning of War of the Universe. That has changed hands, sister to sister. The sisterhood when change everything. Oh! It's a thugnificent. That's it. Could this be it? Jax is gonna be with them for the title. No! Did not get the title yet. Northern Light suplex. Oh, he's gonna do it. Yep, there it is. You can't see Bogard. And here's that five knuckle shuffle punch. Crowd on their feet for Bogard. Picks him up. He's gonna do it. Nope. Oh, right in the arm. He's trying to focus on his arm. And now Bogard trying to focus, weakening him. Using his adrenaline best as he can in order to get in the final entry. But will this be enough? Here comes a lone wolf kick. He missed. Terry fights back. Terry. He got him. Is it really? And he did. F you by Bogard. This is it. One, two, three. No. He did not get the three. And knocks him out of the ring. So close of getting into the Ultimate Survivor match for the VGWGP Intercontinental title. One way to get in that shot. With Miss Montone, Jericho, and Ezdeath. I never see because Jax used to be Justin Jericho's bodyguard. I wonder how this is going to change if he wins tonight. Oh, you got to be kidding me. Oh, no, not like this. Oh, the strength with a tiger bomb through the announce table. How many times are we losing our announce table? Like, my God. Since Hedge and King. Oh, come on. And Optimus Prime and Johnny Cage. And now we got... Oh! Holy! now? Could this be it? Unbelievable. He kicked out from the super kick and gets kicked out. Jax is not gonna let him win like this. Uh-oh, Terry Bogard, watch out! Here he goes! Look at Bogard! Look at Bogard! This is insane. Since his win over Seth Rollins back in Showdown Live last episode in Baltimore, when he beat him because of Akuma, Terry Bogard is stepping up into a new level here in this wrestling business. Oh, he's gonna do the kick again. Will this be enough to put him in the Ultimate Survivor match? He missed it again! Oh my god! What a counter by Jax! He's gonna do the Frog Magnificent. There it is again! For the second time, Thugnificent. Wait. He's not done. Oh no, not this one. Yep, there it comes. This one, folks. Down goes Bogard. Scared the crap out of the referee. There we go. One, two, and there we go. Three. Jax! Is a final entry in the Ultimate Survivor match. What does mean for, more importantly, to Jericho? He used to be his bodyguard to help him defend his belt against Miss Montone. But now things have changed after what happened right now. Amazing counter right there. And here's the ending. Jax taunts in front of the crowd in Pittsburgh, and there it is. That was it for Bogard. There's that pin, two, three, and there we go. Jax has been waiting for this for a whole season. Last time he was in Ultimate Elimination Series was he battled against Jericho and Wild Lobo for the number one contendership for the World Heavyweight title in Warzone brand. And now, we're seeing him finally getting a title shot of his life. Ladies and gentlemen, stay tuned for part 5 here in Warzone, 30th episode.